Welcome to Phoenix, Arizona, home of Super Bowl 49, as the world prepares for a game featuring the NFL's elite. The Foxhole brings you the very best in sports, music, television, film, and more. Now, step inside our hallowed studio for an exclusive event featuring entertainment's elite. It's the Foxhole, live from Super Bowl 49 with your host, Jamie Foxx.
We got Lenny Kravitz right now. With Stephen A. Smith, we got Lenny Kravitz right now.
Nah.
We got Lenny Kravitz right now.
Bad bitches is the only thing.
Yo, stop the music right now. Foxhole, this is how we do it. Lenny Kravitz was leaving. There's a string of models that were following him. I said, could you stop for just a second? He said he will stop for just a second and tell us what he's been working on.
I got all kind of time for you, baby. What's happening?
What's going on?
Good. Is this on?
Yes, sir.
Everything is great, man. Listen, I saw you walking through. I know you're on your way somewhere.
No,
you're
man.
Looking fantastic.
Man, sit down. Relax.
All right. Hold on.
Come on.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
No, you take this.
Yeah, I'm going to slide over this way.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
So
we got time for this, man.
So
we got time for this.
You're out here in Phoenix. Am I on?
Yep,
you're
good.
We're out here in Phoenix, but superstar status. Tell us, what are you looking forward to this Super Bowl? Seattle Patriots, just being here, having a good time. What's it?
Oh,
music?
Well, first of all, I'm just glad to be here.
Right?
Thank God for another day.
Wow.
Right? We're here.
Yes.
Number two, halftime.
Wow.
You know,
ooh.
I'm going to get up there and do a little something with Katy Perry.
Ooh, that's crazy.
Right?
Now, for all of y'all that don't know, this is Jamie Foxx, Foxhole Radio. You know how we get down.
Yeah.
Lenny Kravitz, let me explain something to you. Years ago,
You're
performing in Las Vegas.
Oh, yeah.
I got my homies, I mean niggas.
Now, you roll through.
I mean, it's
some niggas. Black people.
They black folks.
Sorry,
black
people.
They ain't understanding rock and roll. So I got my father's. I said, we're going to see this guy, Lenny Kravitz. I said, wow, really? We go to the back. First of all, we're backstage with you. You're warming up.
Yeah.
You got your hair in braid.
Right, cornrows.
Cornrows. I hope you're not with someone and I'm disrespecting
you. No, go ahead.
But there was a beautiful flower. There was a beautiful flower that was there.
Absolutely.
Who was absolutely amazing that
absolutely.
We were just going flipping over. And I told him, I said, wait till you see him do rock and roll. Wait till you see that. If you've ever had any question about rock and roll, wait till you see him. We go out. There were people to the rafters. You came out. Hair is out now, extended.
Right.
The female drummer.
Right.
Talk about how you, for our listeners, talk about how that came about. You could have went anywhere, but you chose what you chose.
You know, I grew up in New York City.
Yeah.
Born in Bed-Stuy, Brooklyn.
Wow.
But I grew up listening to everything. My family would take me to see jazz, to see rock and roll, to see funk, to see, you know, my very first concert was Jackson 5. At Madison Square Garden when I was 6 years old.
Wow.
With the Commodores opening.
Wow.
Right?
Oh, man. Get
and,
some Jackson 5
yeah.
and Commodores ready.
And you know, if you listen to that early Jackson 5 music that they were doing in Motown, it was definitely soul, R&B, and funk. But there was also a rock and roll element
yes.
in there.
Yes, wow. yes.
You know, they incorporated that Sly and the Family Stone thing, which was part rock, part funk as well.
Yeah.
And then when my mom got the Jeffersons,
yes,
right, we moved out to LA, 1975. So here I was, this New York kid, in LA, all of a sudden in Santa Monica, right, in the middle of that whole dog town, Z boy, skateboard, surfing thing, and all these kids that I met, their parents were hippies.
Wow!
So all of a sudden, I'm listening to Led Zeppelin records, and
Rush.
The Who, and Cream, and Rush, I got into rock and roll. I got into the electric guitar.
Yes.
Right? So that's where it happened. That whole mixture of all of the soul and R&B that I grew up on and then the heavy rock on top.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Tell me this. Get in this quickly. I know you got to go.
I ain't going nowhere, man.
I know, but here's the thing. Tell me the place where you perform. It is the most craziest and it is just, they just can't get enough.
I mean, not to sound funny, but it's pretty good everywhere. But
I've seen you in Vegas. I've seen you in Miami.
No, but I would say the most crazy was I did a concert in Rio de Janeiro.
See? Speedy, you ain't never been to
I gotta go somewhere, man.
On Copacabana Beach.
Are you serious?
And a million people showed up. Literally a million people.
That is amazing.
Yeah, it was incredible. Amazing. On the beach, the water.
Yes.
A million Brazilians.
As well it should. Now, out of those million Brazilians, how many million were Brazilians. Black? That's the new song. Me and Lenny Kravitz, a million Brazilians.
I'm jealous. I'm jealous.
Stephen A. Smith.
What's happening, man?
What's going on, bro?
And now, Foxhole Radio, we're here at the Super Bowl. We have Stephen A. Smith, a juggernaut. And
absolutely.
We also have rock star genius, not just singer, but also actor. What are we doing acting wise?
Well, what I'm waiting to know is what movie are we doing together?
Oh,
because we talked about it. I saw you at the Heat game.
Yes.
Backstage in the club, and you said, we need to do a movie together. Now, I don't want to call you out on the radio station.
Two Heartbeats.
But it's a buddy movie. It's got to be
Two Heartbeats.
It's got to be a buddy movie.
Watch this. I got it. You know what it's called?
What is it called?
I walked up to Jay-Z.
Right.
Don't trip out. I walked up to Jay-Z and said, you know the movie we need to do?
Which one?
It's your song. It's called Niggas in Paris. Only, here's the thing. Watch this.
Right.
We don't call it Niggas in Paris.
Right.
... in Paris.
Uh-huh.
And basically, it's sort of like our Ocean's 11, where these guys who are thieves in America, thieves.
Right.
And all they know is American stuff. They're just sort of lowbrow.
Right.
They get an opportunity to get this big gig in Paris, they're going to go steal the Mona Lisa. It's crazy.
Don't play with me.
My shades are off.
Okay.
I'm serious.
Okay.
Because we've been looking for Make it happen. I'm serious.
Tyrant.
I know you got to run Super Bowl predictions, or you don't even get it.
I'm going for Seattle for two times in a row.
Yeah, two times in a row. That's fantastic.
Yeah.
So am I.
Yeah,
so am
I want to see that. I respect both teams. They're both amazing.
Right.
I want to see that happen.
Brother, it's Fox already.
Wait a minute.
Yeah.
What's happening tonight is the question.
Uh-oh.
Us.
Yeah,
brother.
That is a beautiful question.
Oh, snap.
What's happening tonight?
Jamie Foxx and Lenny Kravitz are going to
tomorrow.
Super after party.
Okay.
It is going to be at the Minnesota.
Right.
And if you need information for that, call 818-3768
right.
and get your tickets. It's going to be crazy.
You still on the same phone number?
Yes, I do.
Okay, I'm going to text you. You're going to tell me where we're going tonight.
All right, thanks.
All right, brother.
Lenny Foxhole Kravitz Radio. Let's see. Oh, snap.
Exclusive.
Benny Black.
That's
come on.
Yeah.
Billy.
I got to get my life together.
Yeah. Let me get a picture. Talk, Speedy, talk.
I got you, dog. Foxhole Radio, we're live. Stephen A. Smith's in the house.
What's
I love the
up?
Suit. I got to get me one.
Thank you so much.
You just did your show.
Yeah.
Which is super hype. And you know a
and
lot
I
of people.
Appreciate, and I appreciate Jamie coming on.
Yeah. And
thank you.
He didn't ask me to come on. But it's cool.
All right. We'll work on that.
So you know everybody's been talking about you and what you said about running back for Seattle.
Marshawn Lynch.
Yes. Which I think is whatever you want to say. My thing is, I don't care if you talk. I could care less if you talk. My kids can care less if you talk. And I just figure, hey, everybody's going after him for whatever reason. You tell me why.
Well,
you
I spoke to Jamie about this, and, you know, I'm going to repeat it to y'all right here.
On the Fox.
Let's be real about something here. And
we have
I am in no way knocking Marshawn Lynch from the perspective that he's not a good brother.
Mm.
He doesn't do a lot of great things.
Mm.
I can respectfully disagree with you about one thing you're doing while still having respect and admiration for you overall. And we got to get beyond that.
Mm.
It doesn't take away from the fact that the belligerence that he's showing is completely unnecessary.
Yeah.
To me, it's juvenile.
Yeah.
And unfortunately, it's counterproductive.
Okay.
You're doing a lot of good things in the community. You're doing a lot of good things for kids, et cetera, et cetera. Did it ever occur to you that for 1 week it shouldn't be about you? That it should be about what you can do to benefit others other than yourself? We understand you got burned before with the press when you was in Buffalo. We understand you don't want to talk to the media. All you got to do is shut it down by saying, don't ask me a damn personal question. I ain't answering nothing about my mama, nothing about my personal life, nothing about my woman, nothing about... And I get that.
Yeah.
But you can answer questions about what you're going to do to New England.
On the field, right? Yeah,
you can answer questions about the sport of football. And I just think that when I see people acting like it's okay, Snoop Dogg and I were texting each other last night, got nothing but love for my brother Snoop. You know how I feel about Jamie. But I respectfully disagree with them on this particular issue because I'm thinking about the benefits of you.
Yeah.
It's not about, there are moments when it's not about you. You know what I think about? I think about Jamie, for example. Jamie, I always use this line. Jamie ain't a black man. Jamie's a brother.
Right.
You understand?
Right.
He's down with a... Don't tell me that don't have something to do with Why Hollywood, despite winning an Academy Award, don't do certain things to hold him back compared to what they do to other people. He can get away with that and still be as great as he is in terms of his contribution, etc., because he resonates that far. Marshawn Lynch does not. As great as he is, there are limitations to how he can resonate.
I'll retort.
When you got that moment, you got to capitalize on it.
This is what I'll do. I'll say this. Some people, a very well-known actor asked me, why did Miles Davis do drugs? I said, because he's Miles Davis.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Why did Elvis do what he did? Because he's Elvis. There are certain people that we're never going to be able to get them to conform because that's not their DNA.
Right.
So what we have to do is say, hey, that's what he is and what he does. He doesn't see it the way we see it because we come from different backgrounds. Wow. I come from, look, I see a different long road for me.
Right.
He may see it as, this is my moment. I want to live within it right now. And this one, I'm giving them entertainment.
But I got to come back at you with
that. Go ahead. Come
you ain't the only one that gets to retort. I understand.
Stephen A. Smith.
Let me get to retort.
Stephen A.
How dare you? You got to see me do my thing.
I know that.
You're talking here. And you come up here talking all that stuff. Marshawn Lynch talking all of this crazy. I wish I would see you. I would slap the hell out of you at any point, anytime.
Here's the deal.
Go ahead.
What Jamie Foxx, same as Snoop Dogg and others have said to me this week, they ain't wrong. But the story's incomplete.
Okay.
Because I'm not in any way saying that Marshawn Lynch can't do that.
Right.
And if that's what you are determined to do, fine. Mm. But damn it, Jamie Foxx ain't Marshawn Lynch.
Right.
Snoop Dogg ain't Marshawn Lynch. Right. What the hell are you defending it for? See, it's one thing for him to say, I'm going to do what I'm going to do. It's another thing for cats like you, me, and others who know better to sit there and condone it. That's my point.
Wow. But watch this. Dr. Dre, who did an album called The Chronic.
Yes, and more.
And he's
the greatest ever. Right. The greatest ever.
And he's a billionaire.
The greatest ever.
So you don't know. Marshawn Lynch may catch another another something out there that we don't even know about, and he may be bigger than all of us, and he may be a billionaire.
I thought I was talking to Jamie Foxx.
And then when
I was talking to Skip Bayless.
And listen,
I thought I was talking to Jamie Foxx.
Will you let me talk?
Go ahead. I'm sorry.
So I let you talk.
I'm sorry, dude.
What I'm saying is this. He could catch a lick because we're in the lick business.
Yeah.
He could catch a lick. He'll be able. Oh, snap.
Cam the man.
Hell no.
Cam the man.
Wow. You need me as wide receiver right now. That's all.
You need all the help.
We got
Under Armour commercials, man.
You need this 5'9" in the 40. Have a seat.
Cam. Wow.
So all I'm saying, have a seat, Cam. Cam Newton has just entered the building. Foxhole is going crazy right now. Keep the ladies back.
Oh my God.
I have just entered the gauntlet.
Cam Newton is in the building. We are talking. He just walked in on a great conversation.
Yes.
He walks in on the Marshawn Lynch conversation. Cam Newton himself has been a person who says, I'm not just in the box. I really want to win. There's a certain thing about me.
One of the best dudes I know in sports.
There's a certain thing about me that is misinterpreted. This guy's been misinterpreted a lot of times. As I watch him, all he wants to do is win. As I watch Marshawn Lynch, all he wants to do is win. He always says,
With all due respect, don't compare Cam Newton to Marshawn Lynch.
Why not?
George, you had to go to commercial. I thought you told me you had to go to commercial.
Fatso Radio, we're going to go ahead and go to commercial. We're going to come back, and me and Stephen A. Smith's going to box.
I'm going to win that one. I'm going to win this one.
Fatso Radio.
How about that
is
commercial?
Crazy. Stephen A. Smith is here. Tyron Turner's here. Speedy's here. There's a lot of women trying to get over here right now because Cam Newton's in the building right now.
Stop it. Listen.
We're talking about Marshawn Lynch.
Right.
We're talking about football players that are not going to be Tom Brady's, that are not going to be Russell Wilson's. They're going to be themselves, and I think that's what makes football interesting.
All I'm saying to you is this. Just because I disagree doesn't mean that I'm condemning Marshawn Lynch.
It sounds like it, though. I'm going to be me, and
I'm just going to say what I feel. When I think about Cam Newton, I see a person, whether you're perfect or not is irrelevant. It's somebody that strives to be the best that he can be, who also recognizes the responsibility that he has beyond the quarterback position.
Right. Okay.
So all I'm saying is that when you say a Marshawn Lynch, I'm thinking about
that. Marshawn right there. Marshawn.
Let him come.
Let him turn around.
I turned around, but I wasn't going to leave.
Okay.
I wasn't going to leave. I just turned around. But my point is.
The new diet pill.
Okay, let me do this.
Let's let Cam, who actually plays football, we don't.
That's right.
Let's let him speak on it.
It ain't about football, but go ahead.
But he plays football. That's what he does. Right. He is in the limelight. Speak on it. Speak on media, how it can help and how it can hurt.
Well, number one, media helps in ways that unimaginable, especially nowadays with social media. You got Twitter. You got people on Instagram straight flexing.
Right.
And they all want to see what is happening now.
Right.
Yesterday.
Right. Yeah.
You know, and with that being such a big thing in this society, you know, it has nothing but goods to offer. But where there's good, there's also a double-edged sword with the bad. I'm just trying to piggyback off of the Marshawn Lynch issue. Now, when you talk about basketball, when you talk about baseball, you kind of get the gist of what type of person is entering the NBA. And without me touching a very tender topic, but when you go in the NFL, it's all different shapes, forms, sizes, creeds, beliefs, religions, and everything. It's more players.
Yes.
You got 11 players playing on the field at one time, whereas in basketball you got 5, and in baseball you got 9. And with that said, you don't actually know where that person's from. You don't understand who that person really is. And when you see a person like Marshawn, who has shied away multiple times of "I don't feel comfortable talking in the media." Number one, first thing that they should put in place is trying to help him.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Trying to put him in the right light to show him that, hey, it's important. It's not just about you. It's about that kid that you would never, ever meet that stays in I-don't-know city in America.
Mm-hmm.
And they love Marshawn Lynch. They eat Skittles because of you. And that's what he see. But yet, the other side is you don't understand what Marshawn is going through. You know, you never know when or how he was scarred in the media.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, what makes that dark cloud come over when a mic is put in his face. So, you know, it's always different types of ways to view a particular situation. And if it was up to me, I would just say, you know what? You know, we have a certain amount of players each and every week that has to go.
I get your point, but here's what I think you're missing. Jimmy Graham.
Jimmy Graham's in the house. New Orleans Saints. It's crazy right now. The ladies are going nuts. It's nuts. It's Foxhole Radio. You know how we get down.
Just got through
it. Yo, it's crazy. The after party's gonna be sick. Jimmy, Cam, Jamie, Steven, Tyron, Speedy. It's crazy after party. Listen, talk about. He's talking from a point of experience. What he is saying is this. We live in a world now, if you do great, they ridicule you. If you do bad, they ridicule you.
Right.
There is no such thing as a media story without a story. It's always going to be something, right? Now, we could talk about, look, I look at Russell Wilson, and I think that's great, drinking milk and going to church.
I'll slap you.
Hallelujah. Yeah. That's great. I dig that. But I like the Deion Sanders of the world.
So do I.
I like Hollywood Henderson,
so
who had a little bit of extra paraphernalia in his towel.
But you don't like
legend.
But you don't like Peyton.
I eat Lawrence Taylor. I like it. I like a little. I want to see a little bit of that. Not too much, because the NFL is, like I said, it's a family thing and thing like that. But you got to give room for color.
Let me respond to that, because I gotta get ready to leave in a few minutes. Let me break this down. First of all, understand something here. Cam brought up a very point in terms of just the different experiences, the amalgamation of individuals, types of individuals that's in the NFL. Number one, that's an NFL issue, not a media issue, because the NFL needs to change that policy.
Yeah.
What they're doing and not doing for their own players is something that definitely needs to be addressed. Cam Newton is absolutely right. But that's not the media's problem, because the media doesn't always have the luxury of just going up to Jamie. If you got a boss that's looking at you and saying, you need to go over to Marshawn Lynch, we want to see what he's going to say today. 99% of those folks ain't Stephen A. They don't have the platform that I have. They can't do what I do. So guess what? They got to go over there. They got to get that interview, etc. Now you look at a Marshawn Lynch. The story, Cam Newton's, I'm not going to let him say this. I'm not going to let Jimmy Graham say this. I'll say it for them. When you look at a Marshawn Lynch, he's a straight brother. You say you look at how he carries
himself.
You're
saying he's a gangster?
No, not at all. Not at all.
I'm reading something.
Not at all. Here's what I mean.
His dread scale.
No, here's
what I'm
saying.
Drinking milk?
Here's what I'm saying. We all know that because he's acting the way that he's acting, as right as he may be, because it sends the wrong message in a lot of people's eyes, another brother that comes along that even looks like he can emulate Marshawn Lynch is going to be held against him. He's going to pay a price.
I will tell you this. If he can run a 4-3,
I'm not talking about somebody that runs a 4-3.
I'm just saying, you're talking about somebody
that might run a 4-5
right.
Or 4-6.
But Steven,
they ain't gonna get
what you're
that
saying
advantage.
Doesn't make sense. Ray Rice.
Oh, everything I say makes
we're
sense.
Not, we're not bringing that up. But there have been situations in football, and we know this, there have been situations in football that have looked way worse than somebody not wanting to speak on
it. No, I totally agree with that.
So you can't use that. All I'm saying is this. Let everybody be everybody. That's what makes
but
us
I'm
great.
But I'm saying that's not reality.
But let us be. No,
but that's
it is reality.
It's not reality.
Jimmy, how are you?
I'm sorry.
Jimmy with the New Orleans Saints.
I'm about to say what?
We argue about this all the time.
Islam, Christianity.
We go back and forth all the time.
Tomato.
Let me say this. First time I met Marshawn Lynch, it was wowing. I'm going to tell you why. I think he was in the same Pro Bowl 2 years ago. He was on my team. And the first thing that anybody would think of when you see the typical guy who wears a grill, who wears the dreads, who's from Cali, you always automatically got this image of it. And the first thing, he cracked a joke. I couldn't tell you what the joke was, but he was laughing the whole time he was there. And it completely knocked me off my rock, because I was thinking, a brother, like you always say, and we can say it, a hard nose, straight out of Compton,
brother.
When you think of
Oakland,
but still, it's like, he's a human being. He likes to crack jokes. He likes to do things. And
give it to you this way: one question. Well, how many people would give him a chance to see what you saw? The typical brother. How many people getting that chance?
Marshawn Lynch? 100%.
Him, yes. 4-3. 100%. The ability that he has.
100%.
But Stephen A.
About somebody a little less.
Stephen A, you know what you sound like?
Eat youngins with this hair and their pants all down the crack of their ass.
Yeah. We old.
But
me and you are old.
That's right.
It's daytime. They own it. I had a meeting with this guy about hip-hop. It was all white guys, and we were in this big super meeting, and they said, we don't understand. And I said, no, you guys are saying urban. Urban has changed. And they were like, well, it's too urban. I said, I want to take
a point.
I took him to a concert, a Lil Wayne concert. And I said, I want you to look around this room and count the urban hands in here. And it was 20,000 white hands going up and down. They don't see it like we see it.
You're right.
We see it in
That's
a different
fair.
Way.
That's
people that wear their hair in locks, or people that are from Compton. My man is from South Central. They're going to bring what they bring. Where's Russell Wilson
from? But,
Jamie,
we ain't talk about them. We talk Russell about Wilson the cats that ain't as gifted as them.
But it doesn't matter.
That's all I'm saying.
It's not about that. You're talking about some intangibles that we can't deal with anyway.
Okay.
There are several people that look different that have succeeded in America. There are guys, most of your billionaires, don't have high school diplomas. So what you're saying is, it's not really fair to put all of that on Marshawn Lynch.
Or what you're not saying, billionaires or people with money that have terrible social skills.
Exactly.
Yeah. Right.
And they got
terrible. And my thing is like this. You can't put Jimmy Graham's in the building. Speak about what's going on. You got degree, dry spray.
Yeah, no,
talk about degree and dry spray. And Adidas. I say it because I hang out of Europe. I hang out of Europe. I got my pass,
right?
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
What's going on with you, brother?
Nothing, man. It's good to be here. Man, I'm here on behalf of degree, and they got a new dry spray out that goes on instantly clear when you put it on. And
Well versed.
And so just go out and try it. I appreciate you. I like your hairline.
You have some on you right now?
It's really nice. This is you right here.
Okay. I like both of y'all hairlines.
Stop that.
I damn sure don't like mine.
I was going to say something, but I'm going to let that go. That's why I got these hats. You got to get you some hats, Stephen A. Get you some hats.
That's all right. I'm 47, yeah. Dog. I'm over it. I'm over
Mace.
I'm over it.
What are you saying?
I'm over it. That don't bother me. No, my hairline is still better than LeBron's and Kobe's.
You better stop it. I ain't gonna say that.
I love them both.
I want that headband. Where,
I'm 47.
Where did you get that headband?
I'm 47, Cam. I'm over it.
Yeah.
I'm over it.
Oh, that's nice.
I just put on some degrees, and I'm fresh and clean for the ladies.
The brother want to ask me a question, Jamie. The brother want to ask me a question. Is that okay?
Do you think sports will ever get back to what it used to be? And when I say that, I had a coach discussion with a coach last night. Not say his name.
Yep.
And I told him back in the day about, you know, let's even say 10 years ago, mm-hmm. coaches got signed and they had a window, let's say from 4 to maybe even 6 years to build a team.
Mm-hmm.
Quarterbacks got signed 10 years ago. They had 3 to 4 years to make that transition.
So what are you talking about? Getting back to what, though?
I'm saying, do you think sports will ever get back to a grace period where they give them time?
In other words, this man comes into the NFL, automatically he's supposed to produce
now. Yesterday.
Magical yesterday. It's unfair.
But to touch on what you guys are saying, it's all about what have you done for me lately. Well, you got a Marshawn Lynch, and I'm trying to tie everything in.
Yep.
We got like a Marshawn Lynch. If he does the wrong things or do this or do that, but he's scoring touchdowns, it's all good. You got a Marshawn Lynch, but he ain't scoring the touchdowns. He's a conduct detrimental to the team, and he's cut. Because he ain't gonna get cut,
but I'll tell you this. Come talk to me when his contract's up and he wants to get paid.
That's unfair.
No, I'm not saying
this. But that's unfair.
I'm not, I am in no way blaming. I'm not blaming him, Jamie, but you're acting like the world is fair. It's not fair.
Wait a minute. What makes you think Marshawn Lynch is going to be a failure after football?
I didn't say that.
No, but what you're saying, wait till his contract is up and the treads dry up and the Skittles are now sweet tarts.
Now he's got a now and later commercial. All I ask is that you portray me accurately. That's all. I'm saying
I'm telling you what the hood is saying.
They say,
black
I hate what?
Football players.
Yeah. Really? Yeah, they ain't saying that.
No.
The hood never say. They would never say that about me because I'm from it. But the point is, I am.
Jimmy?
I only mean that in this sense. He had to hold out for his money this past summer. He deserved his money. Should have been no damn argument. He should get it again. He should get it again. Let's see how they act to answer your question. Let's see how they act towards him in the future. That's all I'm asking.
It's Fox Hole Radio. Once again, it is very heated, but it's very good to have these conversations.
I gotta go.
There are things in what you say, Stephen, that is great. I do think that the position that you in, it's tough because you are a media person. So when you do speak, it goes
flamed.
A billion. So you know that. You've done this job. It could be Stephen A. Smith calling Marshawn Lynch, giving him some wisdom.
I know you do.
But sometimes we also have to understand that these are the jobs that we have. And when Stephen A. Smith says it, it just goes boom. And it's great because you say a lot of great things. You know, I love you. I know you got to go.
Yep.
Fox Hole Radio, you know how we get down. We got Cam Newton, Jimmy Graham in the building.
Why you don't have headphones like the rest of us?
Man, you know, I can't. I feel claustrophobic.
What you trying to say?
I feel claustrophobic. Tyron, ask your question, then we're going to go to commercial.
What do y'all feel about Johnny Manziel? I know we're talking about Marshawn Lynch, but what about Johnny Manziel? What do y'all think?
He need to concentrate on putting in the work these brothers up here put in instead of having a good time. Have a good time after you produce, not before.
Is it the truth, though? Is it real? Or what's your opinion?
I don't think we put them in a situation.
And it's none of our business. Just perform.
He can. I mean, he can do what he wants on his own personal
time. That's right. Exactly.
I mean, Rob Gronkowski has a great time, but he's one of the best.
Winning.
He balls out and he wins. So I mean, regardless of what you do in the off season or what you want to do in your spare time, I mean, do what you want. And if you're balling, it don't matter.
But I think it's when you in that wave of, because I've been in that wave. You can't do no right. You know what I'm saying? No matter what you do, and don't nobody want to hear, oh, Johnny Manziel's in the media, or he's in the film room staying out. They don't want to hear that. They want to hear, oh, Johnny Manziel was turned up at the club, popping Molly, doing this and doing that.
Right.
And that's what get publicized. Right. But
when it's reported, and like in this society, it's always said you're innocent until proven guilty.
Jamie, but nowadays, Jamie, I'm gonna end it like this. Cam, what drives me crazy about what you just said is this. My brother, you work your butt off.
Right.
You are committed to excellence. You ain't throwing a party on a Friday before a game on Sunday. You know that's wrong.
But everything
that's
is,
all I'm saying.
But Steven,
you
everything,
know that.
Everything you say, Steven, flies in the face of some of the greatest football players to ever play the game.
He ain't one of them yet.
Hold on. But the Steelers,
Johnny?
The Steelers back in the day in the 70s.
What they used to do.
What?
They did it when they were winning.
What about the Raiders?
You got to win first.
Listen, the Raiders, the Steelers. Lawrence Taylor was the most flamboyant player.
And it doesn't matter.
He didn't win all the time.
He won when he did that.
But he didn't win all the time, Steven. When he started, what he's saying is these guys don't get a chance.
Right.
They come into the league. All of a sudden, Cam Newton is held to the fire. You got to do it right now. You know
because the NFL is a multi-billion-dollar business.
But it's unfair.
That work with those sponsors.
It's unfair.
And they do it to y'all, not the media.
Also,
the NFL does it to you.
The media too. You jump on.
Hey, y'all sit down.
Don't make me start talking.
What's going on? Hold up.
Don't make me get my Michael Irvin on because you know good and well.
Michael Irvin loses.
Just don't start burping. Don't start hiccuping.
And I'll tell you right now.
Listen, it's just different because of social media.
Right.
It really is. And if you compare things to 10 years ago, I mean, Michael, I'd rather keep it the way it is because honestly, you want to bring it back to the old ways. Well, then you also got to bring it back to the old money. And so with more money, more responsibility, and more media outlets, you just have more responsibility. And that's the difference. You know, anyone can get a hold of and can literally direct message your favorite athlete and or the person that you've always looked up to. When I was young, there was no
untouchable.
Yeah. You know, Jordan, what?
Yeah, right.
Let me meet Jordan. I'm going to tackle him. I'm going to take him home. But it's not
What's
like that.
What do you think about as far as like a running quarterback? I know you do both.
Right.
But I want to know.
I'll give you my take on that.
I want to know what you think about the difference between running and standing in the pocket. Like, what do you like best?
It was a study that was done, and the quarterback is more vulnerable when he's in the pocket than outside the pocket.
Wow.
I tend to disagree.
Because me and Fox always talk about this.
When you're looking downfield, you cannot brace yourself. You know?
Right.
And when you're taking off, everything around you becomes you.
Right.
Sort of, you cut off this defender because he's right here. You cut off that defender because he's right there. When you're in the pocket, your focus is trying to hit Jimmy Graham in this second window. After this safety, you look off the safety to the left. You lose interest or you lose feeling around what's really around. Right. So when you plant that front leg and it's locked out expecting to hit Jimmy Graham on this bender seam, is gone.
Well, here's what I'll say, and I won't use my words.
Right.
I'll use a guy by the name of Aaron Rodgers.
Okay.
We actually talked about you.
Right.
Okay.
I'm on a flight with Aaron Rodgers, and I said, Aaron, I want to know about all the quarterbacks, because I played quarterback in high school. Don't make it there.
Huh?
I said, Willie Beeman. Hey! But this is just a little nugget, so you'll understand. When I talked to Aaron, he said something that was prolific. He talked about the linemen. He said, the linemen that are in front of me, since they knew what they were going to do, their whole lives has been this, to protect the bowl. He says, when you get outside of the bowl, he feels you're more vulnerable. Here's what he also said. He said, what I do, I have my whole life learned how to read to get that tight window with Jimmy because I know as the playoffs come, it gets tighter.
Mm-hmm.
My father was a coach. My father was a coach for 19 years in football. And I will always tease him. I said, black quarterbacks got to stop running. Because I feel that they can be more effective once they learn how to read. And the reason that I said that, my father would say this. When a black quarterback is athletic, they don't develop him like they do white quarterbacks. Am I right? Because they know that black quarterback is athletic. So we just get him around the end because we just want to win the game.
Right.
So, for most people, for most quarterbacks that get to this level who hadn't had a chance to read and be in their pocket, once those windows get tighter, now they've developed bad habits. What, are they taking you out?
Wow.
Cam.
I need
Cam
to, man, we missed something. I need to know
that.
We need to know that.
Jimmy. We're breaking Foxhole Radio.
Take a quick break, come
the
right back.
The establishment is taking over.
Wow.
We got to go to commercial. Long break.
We are live.
We are here live in Phoenix. A beautiful flower. Here. A beautiful flower is coming to sit next to us. Charlotte McKinney in the building.
Yes.
Hey, listen, I'm going to get right into this.
Carl's Jr.
Oh. If it doesn't get all over the place, it doesn't
whatever,
count.
Whatever you want to do. Do what?
They got to turn it up.
You good?
Turn up.
There you go.
Turn up. Turn up. And the, oh.
Oh, I saw that.
She's
saw
trying
that.
To turn wow. up.
She's trying to turn
Charlotte
up
McKinney
already.
Is,
wow. Are they real?
I know you from.
Already?
From
Miami.
Miami.
Mushi, yeah.
Yes.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
You look great.
Talk about this journey. Now, every girl out there, man, has... I mean, Carl's Jr.'s. I mean, that's like the thing right there, right?
Right.
So tell us how you got in there. Because everybody who's out there listening to Foxhole, she's absolutely beautiful right up front. Carl's Jr.'s commercial, how did that come about?
It just came about, really. I didn't think it was for real when my agent told me for a while. But then I shot it and I did it. And
you're killing that burger, I'll tell you like that.
You had the best bite I've ever seen.
Yes.
I did.
Yeah. And it's getting better. Now, are you going to be in Miami on the 7th and 8th?
I may.
Listen, I'm going to tell you something. A friend of mine,
okay.
I'm going to show you this.
Oh, let are me you show setting you, me up with someone already?
No. Okay. Hold on. Let me show you what it is. He actually wants to meet you, but I'm going to show you this.
Okay.
This is the 24th of January. Hey, bro, do you know Charlotte McKinney? I said, I'm good, bro. Do you want me to hook you up with it? He says, yes. You could be my wingman. This is a really good friend of mine.
Who
it's
is
gonna
it?
Blow his it's gonna blow his mind when we take the picture, when we show a picture of it. Because he's absolutely crazy.
What's
about
his
it.
Name?
I don't wanna say it on the camera.
Wow.
He's very sorry.
Come on, Jamie.
Sorry, I can't.
No, I don't care about that.
I know, but I don't
you should.
I don't wanna put him out
you
there
because
he Joe Dirt too.
Joe Dirt 2, aren't
What's
you excited?
Going on? Are you kidding me?
Now, so
how'd
yeah,
that come about?
Me and David have met a couple times, of course. Everyone jokes about that. But
wow, you joke?
Was y'all eating hamburgers?
What?
What happened with you and David?
No, nothing. We're really good friends.
So you
No,
say,
he's a great guy.
Yes.
So we met because I was going to do a show with him. It kind of fell through, and then he called me. He was in New Orleans. He's like, come do the show, the movie.
Right.
I'm like, yeah. So it's a pretty cool scene. You guys will have to check it out.
Now, what are you doing in the scene, or is it top secret?
It's top secret, but I am a logger, a sexy logger.
Is that right?
Yeah.
Now, do I need to prepare myself for this? How sexy is this going
to
get?
You
Should
really
I have my
to.
Cigarettes ready already?
Yeah.
Because you know what I do when I look at you. It's crazy.
Foxhole Radio.
It's Foxhole Radio. We got Charlotte McKinney live in
yes.
person.
Yes.
Where do you come from?
Where do I come from? Yeah. Florida.
You're from Florida?
Florida.
Get out.
Yeah.
Florida. Now, did you always want to be a model or shit just happened?
I always did.
Kit.
Always, yeah.
Were you always pretty in
No, I'm like a swan.
No way.
I was
Get
really.
The fuck out.
No, like
no
you would
way.
Say, I was a little ratchet growing up.
Ah, so you were a black girl with a fat ass?
Yeah.
Wow. So when you say you was ratchet, what do you mean? Was it braces? I mean, what kind of ratchet do you represent?
I had scoliosis.
Oh,
so
shit,
I
that's
was
real.
Like,
oh, your back.
Even when you do that, that looks even better when you do that.
Okay,
they can do it a snake when you want to.
Yeah.
Did you get your back straightened out?
No.
Oh.
So I still kind of stand like this. But I have.
I'm a great back straightener.
Yeah,
I just want to let you know.
But I
even
have
look
these...
at the cops. Look at the cops over there. Look at the cops over there. They're like, yeah.
Hands up.
You see this over here? Look. We might need some handcuffs in a minute. Police officers.
Help me. No, I was just awkward. I just
right.
didn't know. I had these big boobs when I was 14. I didn't
know
what
to
wear.
They are real.
They are real.
Are you serious?
Great.
My boobs are real as well.
Yeah, they're manly
I don't
boobs.
Believe that.
I do. I do.
I don't know. I don't
Speedy
trust you guys.
Speedy has augmentation.
He got an augmentation or a reduction.
Yeah. Well, I got a little bit of an extension, but that's a whole nother thing.
Okay.
So you grew up awkward.
Awkward.
Now,
yeah.
Here's the thing. Are you still awkward in your mind?
Yes.
Does this trip you out that people look at you and like, oh, my God.
Yeah, yeah. yeah. So
when
really...
I watch Carl's Jr.'s, wow. I watch it naked in the shower. Does
no.
that make you feel awkward?
No, not really. That doesn't make me feel awkward.
What type of guy do you like? You said money doesn't matter. Good looks doesn't matter. What do you like? If you saw
it's
a
funny.
Guy, what would make you go, oh, shit, I got a hat at?
Interracial.
Or do you play it back? Is it interracial?
I don't know. I like it all.
Ooh. She likes it all.
Okay.
But you know,
women as well.
No, just men.
Oh, so you never kissed a girl? That's great.
I've kissed one.
You know what's hilarious? Yeah. Let me stop you. I love it when white girls talk about a lesbian experience. You know why? Because it's always that. Like most black girls, I go, have you ever kissed a woman? Motherfucker, don't you ever in your life say, it's strictly, motherfucker, I wish you would. And I'll be, okay, all right. Then I ask a white girl, I said, have you ever been with a woman?
And they laugh.
And they go, no. I mean, I've kissed one, and we dated one in 6 weeks while I was in college. But that's when it was an exchange program. I was in Europe. I didn't know what else to do. And then she stalked me, so I stopped.
Okay, that's interesting.
So when did you kiss this girl?
Oh, no. Just in high school, drunk, at a party, best friend.
And that's all
just
kiss?
Just a kiss. Just a kiss.
In the mouth only? No, nowhere else?
No, just the mouth.
Oh, okay, great. Fantastic. Foxhole Radio.
Foxhole Radio.
It's heating up over here, guys.
It's getting steamy. Yeah.
We got a situation over here.
I'm sweating.
We got a situation. Shout
I may
out.
Have
we got
to take this off.
Oh, there's a degree over here. We got a degree over here.
Okay. Are you a natural blonde?
Yeah, I'm a little reddish, actually.
Oh, okay.
A little...
Everywhere? Like...
No.
Okay, hilarious. Just wondering.
A little honey caramel.
Ooh, okay. A little honey, huh?
Caramel. Don't leave out the caramel.
So here's the thing. Day in the life of you right now. What do? You wake up in the morning. What you doing? You working out? You're not working out?
If I'm not working, I get my ass to the gym every day except Sunday.
Right.
So Pilates, Sunday. Hot yoga.
Shit, man, that's just
sexy. Sexy as a motherfucker.
No Pilates.
I don't even know what that is. What is Pilates?
It's like reformers.
Spread your legs open. Yeah.
You spread your legs.
Oh, yeah. You spread your legs open.
Yeah, like that. You got to get the inner thighs.
Show me a Pilates move. I'm going to come over. Show me Pilates.
All right, so she's going to stand up. Show Fox the Pilates move.
Show me Pilates.
All right, so if they could turn that mic on, I'd appreciate it. And you stretch out your outer thighs. Fox, be careful. Be careful, Fox. Okay, cool. She is stretching all the way down. That's a great move. Fox, you don't need to do that particular move. That's not a good move for a dude. That's not a dude move right there. Yeah.
Oh.
And she twerked.
Okay, all right. We're having fun. Charlotte McKinney in the building. Let me know when you got to go. I know you have to go soon.
Yeah, I don't think that one worked.
Listen.
Don't hold.
Oh, there it goes. There it goes. Okay.
I don't know how much time you have, but I definitely have to take a selfie with you.
Selfie for your friend?
Because my friend is going to absolutely flip out. And he's a great guy.
I'm going to hate him.
No, you're not. You know why you're not? Because I wouldn't even bring it up to you if he was a scumbag.
Hey,
unless you just want me, and then we could just figure that out.
Oh, Fox, you got to be careful.
You're throwing me to your friend.
I'm not doing it. This is what we're doing.
Stay
focused. We're taking a picture just so we could fuck with him a little bit.
Okay.
Because isn't it weird that he texted? I didn't know you were going to be here.
Oh, okay.
They texted me this 6 days ago.
Oh.
No, this wasn't today.
Yeah. Oh,
six days ago.
He had no idea.
No, he didn't have any idea.
Okay.
Yet. So what's next? Where do you go? What are you doing this weekend?
I'm leaving tomorrow. Thank God.
Wow.
Oh.
Yeah, too crazy for me. I have to host Carl's Jr. Super Bowl party in LA.
Oh. What day?
Sunday, yeah.
We're coming.
Yeah.
You're going to LA?
We go back Sunday.
I go back. I'm going to try to go back tonight.
Oh,
we'll
nice.
Come to your party.
You. Yeah,
should we
you
come
should
to your
stop
party?
By.
Yeah. Where's it at?
Yeah, I'm you're serious. Totally I'm
gonna,
invited.
I'm going to come to your party, and we're going to have a great time. Carl's Jr., give me your info.
Okay.
You know, it's only for
work purposes.
Work purposes.
Yeah.
No, that's why I said it on the radio.
Ain't nothing wrong with
working.
I'm twerking and working.
Twerking and working. Charlotte McKinney, listen to all of you. Listen, it's crazy right now. Super Bowl is nuts. The police officers are off duty officially because Charlotte McKinney is sick. Could you wave to the police officers, please?
Look like
could
he's wearing blue over there.
He's still tough. He's still. Can't break protocol.
Wave my baton at you.
Come on.
I'll wave
my
baton at you.
Could you come up? Come up.
Yeah, come on up.
Can we take a picture?
Take a picture.
Come up.
They got to take a picture.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Wow. See? Oh, he came back. Degree guy came by. I got it right here.
Yeah, yeah. Well, let's do a selfie.
All right. Here we go. They're going to take a selfie.
Great to meet you. Love the sandwich.
I love it.
And it's Foxhole Radio. They're taking pictures. It's off the chain. Tyron, what do you think? She's great, guys.
Yeah. So I think she's definitely beautiful.
Yeah, I see you staring, though.
Yeah. Why can I stare?
I didn't see you staring.
But you stare a little bit.
Yes. But you wouldn't see that.
But you're married, I think. No?
It's Foxhole Radio. Big Pippin. Go Saints.
Yeah. I hope you get a divorce, man.
Hilarious. It's Fox, so we're live here on stage. Super Bowl. You've already predicted who's going to win, Tyron.
Yeah, I think Seattle's going to take it.
Seattle. I'm going with Seattle as well. There's a lot of Seattle fans here. They ran out of Seattle jerseys to sell.
Yeah, I just hope they don't change the balls and make them nerf.
They won't do that.
You sure?
My goodness. And you were off.
So we're still here with Charlotte McKinney.
Can I ask a question?
There's no white jeans.
I want to ask a question. Now, I know during those commercials, how many sandwiches did you actually have to buy?
Well, they said, like,
hold that mic up.
Wow, that's in depth.
Shut up.
Yeah, way to get a great question. They said most of the girls, it takes a lot. Like 60.
Yeah. Shut up.
It took me 8.
Oh, did you like ketchup?
I was eating
it, right?
Did you like ketchup or ranch? I'm like,
I like ketchup. Mayonnaise. I have a phobia of mayonnaise, so they made sure
so
the
you don't like white.
No. It really grosses me out. Yeah. I hate
same
it.
Same with me.
Where I'm going.
Yeah,
focus.
I don't like it.
So
let me ask you this. Let's talk about the direction of this Carl's Jr. commercial. We got Beetle Banks joining us.
Hi.
Do they say more? Do they say eat it more happily? Or do they say, what's your process of getting into eating this hamburger?
Oh, when they told me to eat when I was eating it?
Yeah. Like, what you imagine?
Because it looks very sexy. I'm going to bring it up on my phone.
They said, really, really eat it. Just
go ahead and bite into it.
Just really, and it's a big burger, so you really have to.
Oh, that's what she said.
So they let you know it was big. They wanted you to know that.
They wanted me to know the night before. And then some creepy guy the day before was, like, making me practice.
Hey, I got these rubber burgers in my trailer. You should probably come work on it. You know,
not so nine burgers.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this: when you
there it is.
Jesus. Oh, gross! I hate that picture.
Why do you hate this picture?
Oh, that's so bad. Terry Richardson.
Okay, turn. Now, let me ask you this. Why would someone as beautiful as you, because I have this theory that beautiful women on the inside don't know that they're beautiful.
They're the worst. I'm the most.
So what about this bothers
I just
you?
Hate it.
Why?
It's
tell
a
me.
Weird
no,
face.
But tell me what.
It's
tell
bad.
Me what bothers you.
Nah.
Because I started with this picture.
You started what?
And where'd you go from there, Fox?
This is actually a new phone. My other phone is.
But where did you go? I'm curious.
My other phone has
mayonnaise on it.
It has mayonnaise on it.
There's mayonnaise all over it.
Yeah, mayonnaise all over the phone. Look, do you like this picture?
Yeah, I look kind of like a transvestite in that one. Much makeup.
That was the first time I would try you if your name was Charlie McKinney. I'd have to try you right there on this one.
I'm gonna find out if Charlie is Charlie.
That's great, right? That's great.
That's
right there.
That's a little
right?
sexy.
This is very sexy. Guys, if you're out there listening to Foxhole right now, we're not interviewing anybody fucking else. It's over. It's a wrap. All of the guys that are next to me right now, I understand what's going on. Could you wave to the guys? Those guys are working real hard over there.
I love them. They're great.
Yes. Get a picture of it. Get a picture.
I did a great picture with them. Oh, okay. I twerked for them, too.
Oh, did you twerk? Wow. Can you twerk for us?
No, not again.
You didn't do it for us.
You know, more than one in the crowd of the gang.
That's crazy.
Twerk for everybody.
Okay, so.
Okay, so.
Tell me more.
Uh-oh. Tell you more
about what?
About you guys.
This is Tyron.
This is Tyron.
Billy Blanks in the building. Okay. Billy, how you doing, buddy? Doing
Billy, good, what's man? Good?
Celebrity Everything. Sweat. Look at that.
Ooh.
He's ready.
Yeah,
for
I need
it.
To get He's into ready. Your class. What I need to do, man?
Well, you know, we have a workout.
But look at
going
him, Billy.
On. Five, watch your tone. Watch your tone. We got a workout going at 5 o'clock today.
I can't do today.
Lifetime gym, bro.
Tell him this, Billy. No cheeseburgers allowed. it's another thing when you work out with no. So we're gonna finish up with Charlotte McKinney. Promise me you'll take this picture. I'll get your information. We'll come to your party on Sunday. It's
going
to be fun. I'm serious.
It's going to be fun.
All right.
I got some girls from Florida coming into town. Uh-oh. Florida
Talk
girls
Florida.
Know how to do it.
You know how to do it. Now, listen, you're not all tight like people from other places. Like, the South is the best.
The South
I'm from
is,
Texas.
The South is the best. Right. I moved to L.A. I have no girlfriends there because, you know, girls in L.A. just...
Oh, whoa, whoa.
Girls in L.A. are always hating on you.
Yeah, they got the nose
snobby,
up.
Snobby, but there's some good girls, but...
They suffer from the this bitch syndrome. You know what that means?
Yeah.
You walk in the club and they go, this bitch.
Yeah, this
exactly.
bitch.
Because we suffer from the this motherfucker syndrome. When we walk in the club, they go, this motherfucker.
This fucker.
Exactly.
She so, got money.
Yeah.
Charlotte McKinney...
No, but Florida girls know how to do it. We're cool. We don't really give a shit. We kind of got our party
Are y'all first night kind of girls?
First night what?
person, that kind of girl. You said y'all know how to like, do it and y'all different. I'm just trying to figure it out.
Yeah, well, you know, with me, I was first going night. To the clubs in Miami when I was 15, so wow. I kind of got it out of my system.
So you got all that premarital sex
yeah,
out.
It's all done.
At 15.
Oh. Ready to get married, like okay. tomorrow.
That's cool. Yeah, really, early. You're only 19. It's crazy.
21. You brand can say new. 19. That's nice.
She's
nice.
Brand new.
21 yeah. when you're brand new, I tell you what, you can stay. Oh, Lisa Leslie's in the building.
Oh,
you got
oh.
Billy Blanks. Billy, tell her what you're working on right now. We're going to take a break right now. We're going to take a break and we're going to come back with Billy Blanks. We got to go.
Charlotte got to get burgers.
Thank you for hanging out with us.
Charlotte, give us parting words. Talk about your party.
Go all natural.
Yeah.
Ooh. I love it. Yeah, go all natural.
Fox Hole Radio, I'm going all natural.
All raw. Natural now. You thought the little effort that you put in was enough, girl. How about now? Yeah. Girl, how about now? How about now, girl? What about now, girl? How about now?
Welcome back to Super Bowl 49 with your host, Jamie Foxx. They like, oh no. No, 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 please, no. Heard the fans thinking for the door.
I know.
They don't even know what it is.
Bacon I know soda. Nothing but the poor
bacon, bacon soda. I got bacon.
Bacon soda. I got bacon soda.
You know, NFL, the
bacon soda. I got bacon
right,
soda.
Get it.
I'm torn between, I'm a women bad parent, I think, because yes, as I'm riding with my 6-year-old in the back, she just goes, bacon soda.
They sell it in the store, though, bacon soda.
They do. And everybody grandma refrigerator.
Yeah,
so
exactly.
Bacon soda.
I brush my teeth with bacon soda sometimes.
In my fridge.
You
say grandma.
We got.
Keep it fresh.
Lisa Leslie's in the house.
Yeah.
Marcellus Wiley is in the house.
What up?
Lisa, I grew up. Let's go this way first.
Oh.
Billy
Blanks in the house.
Billy, tell us what you're working on right yes. now. I see celebrity sweats.
And I'm going to get to that.
Tybo, the next generation. You know, I've been working
Tybo,
hard.
Tybo, the next generation.
I'm there. I'm
yeah,
there.
You know, working with the new the
I
young
got a new workout tape, too, that's coming out.
Called what?
But we'll talk about mine after oh, yours. Yes. Mine's called Get in Fucking Shape. But I'm gonna, you know, you're going to get in fucking shape. I'm serious. Go ahead.
Serious?
Talk about it.
So, you know, we're working on the new generation, Tybo, and is working with the young generation, you know, really getting them about the college. Because right now, all they're doing is working on computers and
video games,
and cell phones. So my goal is to, you know, get rid of that obesity problem that we have in our country right now. So really working hard at that.
I saw you promoting this. I remember when Tybo... When it first hit, it was great, but I couldn't come to the class. I had to take the tape because the class was like a club.
Mm-hmm. They were there.
I remember seeing Magic and Sinbad in there. Yeah. I was like, it's just them two and like it's like all these women. I said, come on, man. You talk about the start of Tybo.
You know, the way it started off is, you know, I as a martial artist, you know, I started off with martial arts.
You whooped
ass. And became a world champion, and then I retired, you know, and then I wanted to be able to take my skills and put it to use. Yeah. So I started teaching, you know, out of my garage. And from that point on, you know, I opened up a studio in Sherman Oaks, California, and started training people. And the next thing you know, it, you know, became this phenomenon, you know, this exercise that people didn't think would work, you know. And
I have a question. I'm just curious how closely related do you feel working out? What? Working out is great, but what about food? Because don't they go hand in hand? I mean, I do a lot of working out, but I think what I eat is really closely related. And these children, I don't know if they have all the information in terms of food. How much are you, you know, educating them?
I think the most important thing, I work with former President Clinton right now on the program with the kids. And I think they came up with a nice food program. But if you don't get the kids active with the food program, then it's not going to work, you know. Mm-hmm. So I always think if you can get a child active with working them out first, because working out gives you that energy, that gives you the strength to make you become a better athlete, better person, period.
Discipline.
Then once they start to feel good about themselves, then all of a sudden they start to push away from junk food and start to get into eating things that's going to make them perform better.
Billy, have you ever woke up in the morning and said, I just don't want to work out no more?
Yeah, you know, Jimmy.
I mean, every time I see you, it's like, have you ever just been like, fuck it, I ain't going
this
in.
This ain't that day. This ain't that
I'm going to take about 6 weeks. Don't let nobody camera, yeah. Put no cameras
time
on.
Time out, no. Yeah.
You know, I mean,
pad Thai shrimp.
What is it?
You know, I've been working out for a long time, working out since I'm 11 years old. I'll be 60 next year, you know.
Get
so
the fuck
wow.
Out.
Man, being able to do it, yeah, 60 years old.
So black don't crack, out. Huh?
That's
look
right,
at this.
Man. And then eat right and taking care of myself and working out. Yeah, some days I get up, you know, I don't feel like it, but I know when I go do it, it changes my whole day.
Oh, so how important is the protein shake? You know, after I finish my workout, it's like, get that protein shake. Are you big on the whey isolate protein shake, getting those types of?
Well, my first thing is I like to find the good food first. Get the best out of food first. And then when you can't get the nutrients out of food, then, yeah, protein shakes are really good. Mm. But I always tell people first, get the best you can get out of food. You know, I'm working with Celebrity Sweat right now, and it's going behind the scenes, you know, working with celebrities and seeing what celebrities do to keep themselves in good shape.
Really?
Yeah.
I might need you to stop by the house, check out the cabinet, make sure everything is good. You know what I'm saying? Hey,
that Billy Blitz awesome. Is going to come to everybody's
don't
house.
Go to my house. They're going to go bad.
And turn them from a fat.
Give away my Doritos.
What kind of food?
Right, this is what we're going to do. So, Billy, how do we get Tybo 2?
All you get to Tybo 2, go to Tybo.com, and it'll tell you everything that's happening right now.
Let's get into the Super Bowl. We got Billy, but Marcellus, speak on it.
Let's do it.
As an athlete, you see Marshawn Lynch, me and Stephen A. Smith. Of course, Stephen A. Smith, once again, and how dare him talk like that. Is it really a big thing, or is it just we're making a whole lot out of nothing by him not talking to the press?
It's calculated, man, and it's actually genius if you talk about Marshawn Lynch. Man, this is a dude that went to Cal Berkeley, one of the highest esteemed schools in the country. This guy is super smart, got into the league as a youngster, had some transgressions off the field, got a little DUI, hit somebody, the gun charge. But what happened was they stopped talking about the player in a bad way and start talking about the person in a bad way. Marshawn Lynch all of a sudden cocooned himself. He said, look, if you're in the bunker with me, if you're my family, you're my teammate, I got you. You're going to know the real. Everybody else, middle finger. And that's what happened now. So this is a calculated plan by Marshawn saying, I saw how you guys maligned me. I saw how you guys talked about me. I'm not going to let you guys do that to me again.
That is fantastic, man. And you know what? We're going to leave it at that because enough of that. Let's talk about the energy and the excitement of what the Super Bowl brings. Lisa, who do you think is going to win this thing?
Well, I got to give you the backstory.
Uh-oh,
2005, I've been a Patriots fan.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
With them. L.A., we don't have a team. I'm just saying, my homeboys all left SC, went to college. I watched Curtis Conway go. I watched Willie McGinnis went to the Patriots. I watched the Patriots. I was feeling their team game. You know what I'm saying? They're like the San Antonio of basketball. Okay. It's all about team. All right. So I'm not jumping on a bandwagon, so let me just say that first.
Gotcha.
Tom Brady, hands down, one of the best ever to play the game.
Say that again.
Coaches,
say that again.
One of the best ever. ever.
Yeah, I'm fine.
And this is his 6th Super Bowl, by the way.
Hilarious.
So, beyond that.
I like Warren Moon.
I'm just saying, first black quarterback. I'm feeling Warren Moon, but he has not been there 6 times.
Rings. Right.
And he has no rings. So, listen to this.
So, he's better than Peyton?
Yes. No, he's not.
Yes, he is.
Peyton.
Thank you.
Peyton's
better.
Wait, no, he's
not. Peyton's better.
Than
Tom Brady? Yes, sir.
Peyton better than Tom Brady?
Yes.
No,
okay.
He's not.
Not at all.
Okay. How you going to go there?
Now, this is what I wanted.
Listen,
now, this is what
Tom
I wanted.
Tom Brady is better. He's won with less talent. He's gotten the team there. Now, let's talk about the coaches. The coaches, it's a chess match. They're both X each other out.
Yeah.
This is the key factor. All of you brothers must know that when you have that dog and that fight and that thing that you're born with, Seattle's coming with that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's why I think
so
Seattle will win.
Seattle.
You think Seattle will win?
I think Seattle's going to win because defense wins championships and they can change
the
outcome of the
Cam
game.
Cam Chancellor going to be the difference jumping up on Rob Gronkowski.
So let me ask you a question. I do see something, however, in Seattle's play that bothers me a little bit.
Uh-oh.
6 weeks, they have played very, very poorly offensively.
Mm-hmm.
If you look at the Green Bay series, Green Bay, to me, was a one-legged Aaron Rodgers to expose him a little bit. I do feel, in order for him to win, and I hope they do, Russell Wilson has to start during the national anthem.
Yeah.
He has to start immediately.
Right.
He cannot wait till the third and fourth quarter to do that to Brady
that
and Belichick. And I do think that Tom Brady is better than Peyton Manning.
Why you want to go there?
I think he's a better quarterback, and I'll tell you why. He did not have the same arsenal, the same arsenal as a Peyton Manning.
Okay.
Hold on. He had a better defense throughout his career, better than Peyton Manning.
But when
that's
you throw
like that, that's like that Joe Montana Rice, though.
But hold on.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. When you throw to non-named players.
Yes.
You cannot name a wide receiver on any of his teams right now.
Well, and the pros, though.
Not one. Name one that Tom Brady threw to other than Randy Moss. Other than that, name him.
He didn't throw to her name.
Just name him. I'm just asking.
You stuck already. So it's over.
So what I'm saying is,
I just don't want to say the name.
I think Peyton Manning is great. I think he's one of the greatest regular season quarterbacks
you've ever seen
in your life. But there is a certain out that he throws every single time. You can set your clock to it, and somebody gonna get that thing and go six.
Speak on it, Marcel.
Here's the problem. Peyton Manning puts his team in the best position every year to win, succeed, get into the playoffs.
Right. Gotcha.
We all know that he's not the same in the postseason as he is in the regular season. Well, why is because he's so tightly wound. He's so calculated. This guy, when things in the playoffs are plan B, plan C, that means we're going to take away your best things. Right. Now, what is your backup plan?
Let me listen
now,
to him.
His backup plan wasn't like the Patriots, which was cheating. See, that's all that is. If you cheat, then we can go get this all day.
But Marcel, they all cheat. Every team has done that. They're not the first team to ever do that.
Tell a regular person how that helps if you film their practice.
Oh, my God. First, when we line up in a line of scrimmage, what we have to know is run pass as a defense.
Okay.
And we're trying to figure that out in milliseconds. As soon as that ball moves, we got to read that. Mm-hmm. Now, if we don't have to read that because we already know what it is, it's called pinning your ears back.
Wow.
That's the difference between me running a 4-6 and trying to think about it or running a 4-4 and I'm about to bring it.
Right.
Now, you got 11 dudes on that same page where we already know what's coming. It's a wrap, dog. You can't stop that. You're right. Real talk.
Never heard it brought
that. That's messed up. Marcel.
Damn. They know Marcel. Your face.
Brady's dirty. Dirty Brady.
To Jamie's point about the quarterback, I want to know what your take is about the running quarterback and the quarterback that's in the pocket because
I like pocket quarterbacks.
Tell me what your take is.
Yo,
I like pocket
quarterbacks. This is so hilarious that now we're going to limit your abilities and your assets because, one, there was a connotation that was the black quarterback, the mobile quarterback. We went through that phase, right?
Yeah.
I think we've evolved beyond that. But if someone told me you can throw the ball, but you can also run the ball, when does that become a liability that you could actually run the ball? It's all about how smart you are in the moments of conflict.
Right.
And Russell Wilson is smart. When he's about to get hit, he goes down. RG3 is not as smart. When he's about to get hit, he's thinking about one more yard. That risk is not worth the reward. But Aaron Rodgers is a running quarterback, but the paint job's a little different. Andrew Luck's a running quarterback in the sense of can escape.
Okay.
The paint job's a little different. But then when you see the black quarterback and the 2.0s, as we call them, that's what's coming next. Go to a high school game right now.
Yeah.
They are having 6'5" former wide receivers who are the quarterbacks who are going to be the next generation. Cam Newtons and guys like that. That's what's next. You want to have a pure pocket passer? Yeah, if his name ain't Brady or his name ain't Manning, it's not going to last anymore. That day is behind us.
I tend to disagree because I believe in Russell Wilson's situation, Russell Wilson is a manager. I don't see Russell Wilson as a quarterback who is a dominant quarterback.
I agree with that, actually.
I don't believe it.
Most people
I do. I've watched Randall Cunningham die of it. I've watched Michael Vick.
What about
die
Bill Theismann?
Well, Vick was a different reason, though. Vick didn't study, and he already admitted.
Yes.
But here's the one thing about that. Y'all remember this. Tom Brady answered this himself this year. Tom Brady said, I wish I could run better. And that's when things are different.
Let her in.
Come on, girl. Get on the microphone.
Oh,
hello. 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 Hello.
Hello. You sit right here.
You don't know anything about sports.
Christy. Hiya. In the building, baby.
What's
talk, you don't have to talk about sports. Where is John?
John is.
Does he know that this is happening?
And where's the dog?
Nice to meet you.
You better, hey.
Pleasure. So nice to meet you.
You better get some security out here.
He's at rehearsal.
I'm just ordinary people, but I've got no place to go.
Wow.
I can sound like your husband.
No, Fox. She hears John Legend every day. She ain't trying to hear that right now, Fox.
I got to pull back a little bit. How are you?
I'm good. He's down the street, actually. He's at rehearsal for the America the Beautiful.
And I was watching your video, 400 million views on you and your husband's video.
Really?
It's amazing. And I think I was like,
you should see the uncensored one.
Is that right? The uncensored
there
one?
There is an uncensored,
so
yeah.
What were y'all doing in the uncensored?
It.
Y'all was doing it?
Okay. Exclusive.
JL, I see you, baby.
Eat.
Well, you know what? You should do that. How does it, first of all, I'll have to ask him when I see him, so I don't want to make this seem like this one-sided. How is that relationship with you guys doing something where we see you guys in a beautiful light? Is it always beautiful that way?
No, I mean, we keep it real. Like, listen, John, yes, he walks around naked. He plays the piano naked sometimes.
We try to keep it sexy,
but we're also like very lazy, and we watch Real Housewives and
naked.
We're dorks. Naked, yeah.
Y'all watch Love and Hip Hop?
Naked. No, I don't.
So Chrissy, talk about where you come from. Where do you come from? For the Foxhole Radio listeners.
Seattle.
206?
I'm 206. Actually, 425. It's a little bit north.
Spokane.
Snohomish, Washington.
Okay.
No, not Spokane.
Okay, all right.
Not Spokane.
No offense, Spokane. Oh, my goodness. Okay, right. I just offended a whole group of people. I'm from Seattle. I was born in Utah. Kind of interesting.
Wow.
And then came out and got my big break doing Sports Illustrated stuff, and I got very lucky with John.
How big of a sports fan are you? Do you watch a lot of sports?
I am forced to watch a lot of sports, but I cook, actually. So I'm a big, I have a cookbook coming out soon. I'm working on it right now.
Nice.
I'm big in the kitchen. That's where my area is. So I cook for everyone that comes over.
Oh, is it called Cooking Naked?
Yeah.
It's not called that, but it is that.
JL, come on, man.
Hey, Jay, I think everything
I'll just come over
kitchen.
And just this on.
They're just naked,
you.
Little people.
What's all of me? Bring my nakedness and chicken.
Amazing. Are you guys going to the Super Bowl game?
We are, yeah. We are going to be hanging out. We're with DirecTV right now, and we're just kind of running around the city and having a... We don't have that much to do, honestly. We're just kind of cruising. That's why I just hopped in here.
Well, I'll tell you what. You guys, listen, I know you guys got to go. You make it absolutely look fantastic.
Thanks.
What's your prediction? I know you're not into that, but what do
I'm
you think?
I'm going to Seattle, of
there
course.
There you go.
Of
got
course.
You, baby.
Are you?
I'm going to Seattle.
Wilson.
We're all going
to
Seattle.
Him.
Russell Wilson, drinking milk, and Kristen, I love it.
What's up with all the good people you have? I mean, I don't
I'm just saying,
it.
He's a great...
You were talking about Peyton Manning doctors the other day. I mean, you got to stop.
Anyway, this guy here, man.
He calling you out.
This guy
he
here.
He got records.
So thank you so much for coming and blessing
me.
Us.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Yes.
All right. It was such a pleasure to meet you.
Right. You guys have been so pretty.
Thank you, baby girl.
You guys are
appreciate
so pretty.
The visual for the naked.
Yes, thank
love
you.
Love the kitchen.
So what is this video y'all talking about?
Kitchen love.
All right, I'm going to come back. Please let me come back to this. Please.
Okay, let me hear about this video.
Foxhole Radio, we're taking a break. We'll be right back.
Lisa
Leslie, Marcellus Wiley, and some niggas.
Oh, my gosh.
Super Bowl.
Yeah.
Super Bowl.
Seattle.
Super Bowl.
Seattle.
Parties galore. Marcellus. Leslie. What's your name?
What's your name? Mine is
Speedy.
Lisa Leslie.
20 years,
Lisa
bro.
Leslie.
Yeah.
20 years.
Sorry.
So. 20 years.
Speedy.
20 years.
Tyron. We are into it. Tyron. Kane from Minnesota Society. We always talk about the black quarterback. And I say, this is what I say. My father was a coach for 19 years. My father would talk about the black quarterback. He said, it's a blessing and a curse to have athleticism. He said, because as a black quarterback, we develop them differently than we do white quarterbacks.
Mm,
reason
true.
Being, if they got athleticism, I don't want them to drop back and read. I just get them around the end because we're trying to win the junior high game. We're trying to win the varsity game. And those players at that time don't have the level of skill all the way up to college. We still use their athleticism. So therefore, they don't get a chance to stay in the pocket and read. And on that level, you have to be able to read. If you cannot read, the running and everything else, like when you say Aaron Rodgers or these other guys who run, yeah, but Aaron Rodgers, as I'm talking to him on the plane, he says, listen, I don't know what all these other quarterbacks do, but what I do, I study. And all I've done my whole life is study and read. So that's all I'm saying.
Right. So was Steve Young a running quarterback?
I think he was a running quarterback, but at the same time, he could read. And so my thing is that we develop black athletes in the quarterback position differently than we do.
Right.
Well, your father definitely is on to something, and he's right, because I don't think if you're a running quarterback, let's use the cliche, you maximize both resources, which is the ability to read in the pocket and the ability to run. One of them usually gives to the other. And we don't see a lot of guys who maximize both. Aaron Rodgers is right. But if we look at Fran Tarkenton, we want to go back to early Joe Montana and definitely Steve Young, three white quarterbacks that were running quarterbacks but didn't get the same label when we see Cunningham doing the same thing because Cunningham didn't have the same results. But if you want to talk about the elements in the pocket, Cunningham used to throw that thing from the pocket, but then what we used to lead SportsCenter was him running out the pocket. And I think revisionist history, we kind of forget. Warren Moon wasn't a running quarterback. Warren Moon broke that thing down, even though he could move. He was a pocket passer, didn't give the opportunity to be that guy.
Doug.
Super Bowl.
Doug
Super
Williams.
Bowl.
He didn't run.
No, he didn't.
He didn't run at all.
Couldn't. No, he couldn't
but,
run.
No, but listen, he didn't run at all.
Couldn't run.
Well, he could read.
But that's because they couldn't run.
But what I'm saying is this. I think it benefits a quarterback better to not be able to run as much and read more. Because when you get to the level that he's at,
he's right about that.
But what happens if Peyton Manning run a 4-3? Then you tell me what happens.
We both saying the same thing in a complex way. Look. The best thing you can have is a running quarterback who can sit in the pocket and read it. But we don't see very, very few. Aaron Rodgers might be the best one. Andrew Luck is number two in that world. But here's
Mike Vick?
Mike Vick didn't study the game enough. He even admitted it. This is his own words. He said, I didn't study the game enough to know the complexities of defense. But if you look at it now, if you could get a guy, a Frankenstein lab kind of quarterback, that's what they're looking for. That's the guys. And we saw this year. You saw it in the national championship game. You saw Cardale Jones, 6'5", 250, running around and then picking you apart from the pocket.
I think you should have came out.
I would have came out.
I would have came out.
You got to come out right there.
What are you doing?
You can't do any better.
What are you doing?
Ever again?
What are you doing? Get out!
He got recruited again. Urban Meyer sat him down again and said, "Look, dog, where you going? Because we need this here.
You need a show."
All I'm saying, I would always kill him. I said about the black quarterback, but at the end of the day, like I said, when you stay in that pocket, you got to understand this. The linemen themselves. Their whole life has been this. Yeah. Protect that bowl. True. When you break it, look at the quarterbacks that have died out there. RG3, they knocked his leg into the concession stand. When they got his leg back, it was all types of nacho cheese and popcorn.
They got Joe Theismann before him.
I know.
And Joe Theismann was a
pocket passer. But let me just intervene.
Tom Brady
and say
got
this.
Hurt for a whole year.
Bledsoe got
knocked out.
Is RG3 a better quarterback in the pocket than Tom Brady?
We haven't seen.
Oh, my God. That's not even a question.
That's what I'm saying.
Listen, it comes down to education. This is the thing that I can tell you. When you are black, as we all are sitting here, you have to be better at everything.
Right.
Reading the defense, playing in the pocket, running the ball, and it goes across all sports. Yeah. It's just like if you talk about brothers playing pickup, well, we know some people who were great, but you put them on a team and they're like, what a defense. And you got to guard somebody.
And,
How about this? The 8-foot mid-range.
Right. So it really translates across in terms of educating yourself. If you want to be a quarterback in an NFL, it's best to be able to do both. You have to be able to make reads and study the game, not just play it. But I think that our coaches are doing our black young men a disservice by just trying to win games as opposed to teaching these kids how to play. And it's called fundamentals. Yeah, you want to be able to play pickup. I played pickup, but guess what? I went over and played with some other little girls with their hairs all braided up so I could understand how to play a 2-3 zone and a 3-2-1 and a full court press and a run and jump. You got to understand and educate yourself. But let me segue here because we are here not just for football. We're here for education. This is National School Week.
Yes.
And our nation is all about school choice. Mm-hmm. And what does school choice mean? It means that kids should not have to go and attend schools just because of their zip code, where they live. Oh. And what's happening, especially in the inner city, a lot of our schools are underperforming. Mm-hmm. We're not against public schools. We say, great, if you find a public school, go. Mm-hmm. Public, private, whether we're talking about homeschooling or charter school, our kids need better education. So we're using our celebrity and our voice on behalf of American Federation for Children and trying to get the message out there that we need to make sure that our kids are getting the best education possible.
Right.
Well, I'll tell you this.
That's beautiful.
I think it's absolutely sad that we live in the best country in the world and we pay our teachers, because my father was an educator,
25,000.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. Maybe 30,000. Yeah. We've taken the discipline out of the school. It's tough. So all those teachers out there, like I said, my father educated for 19 years, Black history. My grandmother had her own nursery school for 30 years.
Wow.
So education is key. It's just you tell me where to go and what to do. We're down. We'll do it on this show. We'll make it big. Because the problem is this. People don't understand the internet. When the internet and what we started doing here left millions of kids behind because they couldn't even read. So now when you have that, all these kids are sort of walking around in the dark. So with that education process, I'm watching it.
Yes.
You see these kids out there now, when I go to these inner cities or even in the suburbs.
Yeah.
They don't know anything about anything. I took my daughter, and it doesn't mean private or public. My daughter went to a private school, and I had to. It's tough there too.
Yes.
Because now it's La La Land, and it's they don't really get the real. Yeah. You know?
But they're gonna take your money.
Man, when I tell you.
I mean, you can't tell. Month. I think our kids are the same. You got a 6-year-old, right?
I got a 6-year-old, yeah. And I got a 21-year-old.
Right. Mm. But the times have changed.
Yeah, my 21-year-old, you know, some of the stuff we had to teach her ourselves because they wasn't getting it in the curriculum. And so I'm completely behind that. Anytime you need us,
I'm going to call you on
this,
Jamie.
What do you guys feel about discipline in the schooling? Like, do you feel like we need to do more discipline with our children? Or do you, you know what I mean? Because it's like controversy, like, you know what I mean.
Well,
like,
the first level of discipline has to come at the home. Yeah, I mean, the home level. We've seen this all deteriorate before our own eyes. One of the easiest barriers of entry in this world to show true power and creation is having a child. That's why you have so many teenage pregnancies, because when you want to feel like you're big, bad, and you're doing something in this world, but you don't want to go through normal, proper steps, education, wait for it to pay off long run, you try to jump past that, and then also you want to have a kid and you're 17 years old.
Right.
All right, not a problem, except now you have a burden and that's going to come with some issues. Mm-hmm. What we're seeing right now is those young parents having kids and not knowing who they are, therefore not knowing how to raise those kids properly and not knowing how to discipline them. The discipline is not about spanking. The discipline is about alignment, putting them in the proper place mentally so they could do the right things in this world. The worst thing you can do, and I get this from Bishop Noel Jones, is raise a child the wrong way. Worst thing you can do out here, because once you get that kid off course, he's going to not only stay off course, more than likely, but grab others. And now we have a community of people who've been grabbed in the wrong way.
Wow. Listen, man, I'm going to say this about I'm going to say this about you, too.
Off chair.
I mean, I talk about Stephen A. Smith all the time.
You guys are very smart.
And, you know, he says a lot of good things, and he says a lot of goofy stuff, too, and that's part of his thing. But when you guys speak, man, I don't know if you know what it's like watching you guys. We always know it's going to be the right thing.
Mm-hmm.
You're not going to run from anything. And that what you just said right there, that cuts through whatever we could do, whether it's putting a show together and shooting it ourselves and talking about that. Because what I see out there is there's no outlets where we get a chance to talk to these kids and parents at the same time. I run into a lot of parents. I'm 47.
Yeah.
So I run into a lot of parents that are 35.
Yep.
You know, 28.
Right.
Just don't know where they're going. So hand to hand, we'll do that. And Foxhole Radio, man, it got serious.
It got real.
It got real.
Yeah.
And the Super Bowl will be won by?
Seattle.
Super Bowl will be won by?
Seattle Seahawks.
Score prediction?
I say 17-13 Seattle.
No, it'll be more than that.
You think more than that?
Yeah, hey, Fox, who you think going to win?
It's tough, man. You're Seattle. On the fence,
and
right?
The reason,
I'm going Seattle.
And the reason why I asked you this question is because we have a running, per se, quarterback going against a passing.
No, you have a defense going against a passer.
Right.
I don't see Russell Wilson as...
But we got to give him credit. You can't win a Super Bowl without him.
But I'll tell you what he has to do. During the national anthem, he has to get the offense
get
going.
Ready.
He can't wait to third or fourth quarter to beat those guys.
But let me say this. The only thing that I say about the Patriots defense, they're not necessarily blitzing and rushing him so much where he's actually going to have time to make throws, I think, more than normal. But his throws have to be accurate.
Yeah.
And that's where I think the Patriots defense, sometimes they switch it up zone, and you don't really know. He has to be able to make his reads sharp. This team is the best of the best that you're going to face. Wow. But on that flip side,
Tom Brady don't like getting knocked down. Don't hit him too many
don't
times.
Make a move.
And I'm telling you right now, that Seattle defense, they're nasty.
Dude, somebody can.
Dude, how am I looking?
They're nasty. Like Sherman said. You mad, bro?
Let me talk about what you said. You blew my mind with the Tom Brady and the cheating thing. I think it really hangs over them.
Oh, definitely.
I think it does.
It hangs over me, man.
I mean, it hangs over.
There's no way. Like, when they got caught, and this is let you know how egregious it really was. They burned the tapes. Now, hold on.
It should have forfeited it. You got to forfeit.
One thing is to catch you, and another thing is we got the smoking gun, and everyone says, what was on them? Oh, we burned them. Why did you burn those tapes? Because of what you said. This is not the collegiate level where you can just go back and say, okay, we want your Heisman back. We want your national championship back. Where do you start this if you're the NFL, and where did it end if it's the NFL in terms of impact? So they couldn't go back and say, oh, we're going to strip you of your last three Super Bowls.
Right.
So they didn't even want to address it at all. You talking about a scandal? It was next level, but it just got buried.
Now, so we were talking off thing. Please explain to the regular guy driving in his truck why a deflated football is easier to catch in the cold. Not saying that's why they won, but why is it easier than a one that's really hard?
The most powerful thing on a football field is that football. The fastest thing out there, because speed kills, is the football. Black quarterbacks, listen to this. You fast, but that football faster than you, brother.
Yes,
trust me, okay?
Yes.
So chill out with your legs sometimes. Here's the thing. That football, when it's not at the proper PSI, it's all of a sudden spongier. When it's a little softer, easier to grip as a quarterback. When it's a little softer, easier to catch as a receiver. When it's a little softer, easier to tuck in as a running back. You play with a compromised football. Now you got the vehicle to now control all levels offensively. And I don't care how great your defense is. You ever seen a game lost 3-0?
Marcellus.
Yeah.
Marcellus,
what's up, brother?
You're wrong. ESPN did a thing on sports science.
I saw that. That's my dog Rinkus.
So it's wrong.
No.
2 PSI is what the ball was deflated by.
Yes.
It's more weight by rain hitting the ball than the 2 PSI. The average human being cannot squeeze the ball 2 PSI. So it couldn't have made a difference on the field.
Yeah, I saw
I'm just telling you.
You're doing a comparison between elements. You're not doing a comparison and an absolute comparison
between
two balls.
He go to college. He hit you with elements right in your head.
Don't give me the elements because every game is not a rain game. All I want to compare it to is another ball.
Yeah.
That's an absolute experiment.
But you cannot. The average human being cannot squeeze the ball.
We did this experiment on NFL Live. They threw it to three analysts, and they said, we're going to give you a blind test of the three balls. One's overinflated, one's normal, and one's underinflated. Every single analyst got it correct. Trust me, brother. I played every level. Pop Warner ball.
You ain't playing no football.
I get it.
That's Kevin Frazier talking. That's Kevin Frazier talking right now.
And if it has no impact, just think about it logically. Why would you ever have a PSI rating if you're saying the 2 PSIs have no effect? Why would the NFL put a range that they say has no effect? Because they know that range has an effect.
But they didn't go past that range. They didn't go past 2 PSI.
No, they went
under. You came over here with your hot ass and go try to go
Kevin Frazier.
Now you're talking quiet.
What's your porcelain team?
And then all of a sudden you say, well, you know the thing about it.
With a good team, Jay.
You can go to Dave Buster right now and get a softball, and you say, oh, let me get on Papa Shot all day with a little softer ball. Just that little difference is a little deader on the rim. Well, in football, it's a little deader on the fingers. That thing sticks, bro. I'm telling you.
What if I scored a game, Marcellus?
Oh, you gonna fell into the trap now.
Ooh,
here's the thing. Football, more than any other game, is a game of wheels, a game of momentum. So let's go back to the first quarter. And let's go back to halftime when they were only down 7 points. You trying to tell me if they didn't have a compromised football and they didn't have that one play early in the game, the whole game complexion
changes. What has been their issue all season long?
It's not about results.
What's been the Colts' issue all season long? What was it? Slow starts or mistakes by Andrew Luck? They couldn't get out of the block early on, and New England hopped on them. That's what they did because that's what they do.
Watch this. Kevin, if I tell you that in basketball, to take a charge, you have to be out above
the arc, right? The arc.
If there's a charge and you're behind it, but I feel
it's
you shouldn't call that. Regardless of what I feel about it,
it's a rule. It's a rule.
If the rule is
to level the field,
to keep the football at a certain weight, you're cheating.
Yes.
At the end of
the day. And why? What's the motivation? Because you know it has impact.
Here's the thing, Kevin.
Why would you cheat if it has no impact?
Why? I'm not even going to say why. I'm not going to say the why. I'm just going to say you cheated.
Yep.
And at the end of the day, when you cheat me, I'm like, I used to tell cats all the time, I play basketball, I wasn't as good as y'all.
It's all good.
Her, not me.
I said, the only way you're going to beat me today is cheat me. When you cheat.
Yes.
And here's the thing. All of the things that goes around in the NFL, my man not talking on the thing and da-da-da. But when the darling of the NFL says, it's a little disingenuous. You cheated, no matter what it is.
Yep.
No matter why you did it, you did cheat.
Here's a good example.
So here's the thing.
Too.
If you pull for the Patriots, yeah, it don't make no difference. But if you're someone who just brought me to light about the cheating thing, I was like,
yeah, man.
It just makes it
let me give you just one example. Boy, and I know we all have been there. You ever had that final exam and you're sitting there like, damn, everybody told me this teacher go hard. This test going to kill me. So what you do is you get that scientific calculator or you write all the notes on your hand. Mm-hmm. Whatever you do, you got a cheat sheet. Now, you saying the score, 45-7, who cares? You didn't even need a cheat. But you walked into this test and you had your cheat sheet on your hand. Took the test, and then realized, I don't even need that cheat sheet. But what happens when the teacher walk up to you and say, let me see your hand?
Yeah.
You ain't used it yet. You didn't even need to.
Yeah,
how you got it.
He still got the evidence on him, though. That's what he's saying.
Down goes Frazier.
I got to stop doing things with Jamie around.
Down goes Frazier.
I got to stop doing things with Jamie around.
We got to go. It's Fox News Radio.
It never works out.
Absolutely incredible.
Marcellus, I'm going to give you a show. I know you got one, but I'm going to give you another show.
Fox News Radio. What's it?
We out.